Today we're going to be starting a new Traveler's Notebook art journal. I'm using the Dyan Reaveley Dialogues because it has such great paper, and I'm going to tell you all about it. I am going to start a little series because I feel like I don't journal enough in my art journals. They're big and they're kind of more fancy and more special. So I am going to start using my traveler's notebook to be a kind of portable art journal. So I wanted to show you, we're going to start with a blank one. And I'm going to tell you all about this kind of special traveler's notebook for art journaling. And we're gonna play in this, right? So first off, a traveler's notebook is generally, you know, tall and skinny. I don't know how big this is. Hang on. It is 8 inches by 4.5 inches. And most of them that you get are for planners, right? Lots of the planner girls use these, and this is originally what I started mine with. But Dyan Reaveley has special types of traveler's notebooks. These are regular bound, so you can take out the pages if you need to, which a lot of times I'm going to have to, I assume, since I do more, like I put stuff in my art pages. But they also have these handy dandy things. So this has a little folder. So this is a little folder where you could put business cards, things like that, right? I just took out all of my my credit cards and stuff so you couldn't see them. But so what happens with the traveler's notebook is you have this little band, okay? So I only have one band in this one. I have two bands in this one. And you can thread them through. And so then what you do is when you have a new notebook, like this one, you can either put it down the middle. I tend to put them in the front cover, okay? So you're gonna pull this up. You're gonna pull this band up. Oh, there's another band. So we could use the blue band. So you're gonna pull the band up. You're gonna put this in, and then you have it to write in, right? And I've gotten to where I can have maybe three of those in there with the other stuff I have, because I have this is a folder that you can use. I have some little, these are specially sized stencils. You could cut any of your stencils down, but like this one is a specific to planners. So when I used it more as a planner, you can make cute little banners, things like that, okay? So you can put those stencils in there. And they're made specially for the stencils. And then you can have like a little place to keep things. And you'll see I have all kinds of notes from wherever I've been. This is what I use to do my planning. So here is some videos I want to make. Here is where I'm meeting with my friend. Here is Santa for last year. Am I going to just do them on here? No, I have these other books and I'm going to use them as backgrounds because I don't need to know. So there's my goals for this year for my website. Here is some more video ideas. There's meeting with my friend Kirsten. There's meeting with my friend Barb. So I use this all the time. This is super important to me. And I carry it around with me. So I thought it would be fun if we would make a journal for the other one, right? So we're gonna use this one as an art journal. And I'm gonna start just getting some backgrounds and things like that on here. I think I am gonna take a couple pages out. So this is called one signature, right? So you have the stitching along here, and then you have one signature, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, let's call it 13 pages in it. So number one, I am going to rip out the page in the signature, but you want to be careful. You actually want to, you don't want to, you can do it this way. So I'll do one of them this way. Okay. And, but what you're doing is if you take them all out of the middle, you're weakening the, and they aren't going to rip very well anyways. You're weakening the threads of this signature. See how that one got a little bit loose? So instead of doing that, what you want to do is you want to come back one, two, three. So this is three. So I'm going to rip this one out. Okay. Boop, boop, boop. And then one, two, three over here is going to just come out because we've ripped the two sides of the signature apart, right? So I'm going to do that for now. That's going to make it a little bit skinnier. Maybe we'll do one more set. So one, two, three is where we took it out. Four, five, six. So we'll take this one out too. And these are excellent papers. Okay, so let's talk a little bit about this paper. So most, it's going to be one of these. There it is. So most of these, any kind of these that you buy are not art paper, right? They're typing paper. But Dyan Reaveley is this crazy girl. I'll put a link to her channel. You'll love her. This crazy English woman who uses her traveler's notebook for her art journal. So she puts art paper. So this is craft paper. Here, and I will be using those inserts for other things, right? But I wanted to start and get just a little bit on these. I'm going to keep this ongoing. This is the intro, but I will be doing lots of these. But to start, I just wanted to get some stuff on here. All right. So I am going to put, I love this. I think my father-in-law gave me this as a, in a present. So I think I'm gonna make this middle page, this tissue paper, because it'll make me think of him. But I don't want it to cover, of course, the whole thing. So let's rip this, and let's rip this. And do we want to? So if I get a lot of glue down the middle, especially of this, the inside of the signature, it could make tearing out the other ones harder because it'll seep down into that hole. So I think I'm gonna try to avoid getting too much glue in there. So let's do that. Well, we might as well use this one. Okay, so I'm just gonna put Mod Podge. This one's almost done, never fear. I got another one in the drawer. Ooh, that's an old brush. Okay, so we're gonna just put some of this in here. I'm gonna try not to glue my pages together. Having worked with other stuff, I know that I'm good at gluing my pages together. My husband bought me waxed paper so I could try not so hard to glue my pages together. All right, so let's put this on here. Let's get another little piece over here. I like my pieces to be square. You may not care about square, but I like square better than... Not square as in no raggedy edges, because I love raggedy edges. Square as in I like right angles. I like this is a little weird for me. I would rather have this be kind of, you'll see. So I would rather have this be squared off. See, square. Okay. I know, too much information. Okay. Boop. And I'm gonna leave this hanging over the edge so that I can rip it off. Now, I don't want to cover all of, ooh, that made a really nice, I don't want to cover all of this with Mod Podge because then no inks or anything will absorb into it, right? So I'm not making this a base layer. I'm just making this some interest in the back. All right, so let's go a few pages. Because what my goal is for this is to be able to take this with me, and when I'm dinking around, I can doodle in it, I can write in it, I can actually journal in it. I just think this seems like fun. So, until I do something more interesting than glue down tissue paper, I'll probably fast forward to. Okay, now I want to mess around a little bit with putting colors into my book with the gel plate. So let's go with the colors we have in here. We have purple, green, yellow. Yellow's my favorite. So let's do a lot of yellow. We got some pink. We got, and I glued my pages together. You might not like this, so if you don't like this, see, I glued that together, I had to rip it apart. So, if you don't like to glue your pages together, if you like perfect pages, then wait between them. So, I just got done making the secret tuck spots. You are going to be able to watch that in a different video. I'm gonna cut off the edges of the secret tuck spots. I did some of them upside down accidentally, but I think it's a very, very cool thing. I would never have done that on purpose, but now I feel like I've discovered something new that I can do. I'm just trying to get any of them that are super, super far out. That one's a little funky, funky. All right. So now, let's do some. I'm doing a little bit of gel plating. Okay. All right, so we have two different colors of blue. One's a metallic. I don't know how that happened. And then this is one of my best colors of blue, but it's running out. And then I got some orange and kind of magenta. And then this is muted gold. I'm on a little bit of a gold kick. All right, so we are going to do this. Look, I got this at the Joann's, and I just love this. This is a sidewalk stencil. So what we're gonna do is, I have an extra side stencil, I have an extra side gel plate that we're gonna use also in conjunction. Okay, let's pull ourselves together. Where's our lid for our very special glue stick? All right. Okay. So what you want to think of with your gel plate is you are going back to front, right? So you are starting at the very first layer is going to be the front layer. So you want it to be light colored. So I'm going to make it orange and yellow and maybe a little bit of gold. So we're going to make a little palette over here. With our, so much paint, too much paint. Okay, so we're gonna just make a kind of ombre over here, which we have way too much paint on here. But I'm gonna do, I kinda wanna make sure Oh, good. I have two of these. Okay, I just want love. All you need is love. Okay. So all I want is love. Okay, and I am going to try to get the whole word love in here. Okay. All right. Sweet. And then we have this fun little bit over here. So, and I put this on backwards because when we make the pull, the final pull, it will be forward. Okay? So I'm going to put this off to the side. Actually, we can do this. You ready? You ready for something fun? Let's do this. See how love is kind of in there? That's fun. I like that. Okay, so we have this on here. We need to let that chillax for a little bit. Let's do a whole kind of orange yellow thing going. So as you can tell, this is a huge gel plate. I've got a little tiny thing, but what we can do, I'm gonna show you. Give me 1 second. Okay. And all I'm trying to do here is start to get some layers. There might be enough to get another layer of off of here. There we go. Just little bits here and there. Okay. All right, let's. I'm not getting through there at all. But when I roll that, I'll get a little bit on there. Must be a very fat stencil. That Tim Holtz, darn him, he makes too good a stencil. All right, let's cover up some of our things. Circly bits. All right. Now what I'm gonna do is take this. And this is why I like having them on the acrylic blocks. I'm going to take this. And kind of make little blocky areas with it. How cool is that? There we go. All right, so that's getting a little bit of color back there. Just touched orange again. All right. So let's bring this back. I bet you this has a little bit dry. This is why I like using a couple gel plates at once. Now let's do it. I don't think that's dry. We've got to come back to love in a minute. Okay. All right. So now let's do, what color are we going to do over love? Behind love. Let's do blue and blue. Blue and yellow? No, that'll make green. We don't want green. Let's just do blue and blue. And it'll have a little bit of orange in it because we got it on the brayer and on the gel plate, but that's fine for me. Okay. All right. Let's come over here. So what I'm gonna do is, while we're just messing around, there we go. So now, I just want to come over here with this. We're going to put it over top. So we want to start incorporating some of the elements of what we have going on. So I don't want to have, I definitely don't want to have like the gel plate come to here, right? And then that start, because that's where it starts looking like it's not all one thing. All right. So that was a little muddy. It's fine because we had the, still had the yellow on there. What do we want to do? We want to, okay, this is what we're going to do. You're going to like this. I'm just trying to make some fun stuff, right? This is a play journal. This is a try whatever the heck you want journal. All right, so we want to move the paint. When you take it off of the plate is when you can move the paint around a little bit more. All right, so I don't mind that I have a lot on there this time because we're going to do this. We're going to put this on here. We're going to kind of get it stuck there. And then I'm going to use this almost like a stamp. Okay. There we go. So now we got some circles. So don't forget, we're going to have circles on this side. Let's go to a different page. And there we go. That's cool. Okay. And then we have circles over here too. Let's see, do we want to do that? Nice. Oh, look, we get a tuck spot. Sweet. Okay. That's fun. Okay, so we're starting to have some good color in the back. All right, now let's check our thing again. Okay, it looks a lot drier. Does it look a lot drier? All right, so what we're gonna do is we're going to just very gently get the extra, see how there's so much paint there? Get the extra paint off of there. All right. Because now I want to get serious about doing another layer. What do we got? What do we got? We want those circles? No. I want littler circles. I want littler circles. There's littler circles. There we go. Oh, good. Those are the same circles I used before. So I want to get these littler circles. Behind the love. Because now we're making layers on the gel plate. Okay, so those circles are going to be there. Let's do a little edgy edge thing. That may be enough. I mean, I don't want this to be a huge thing, so let's let that dry for a minute. All right. All right, so we have paint on here. So if I just use circles and chevrons, so I already have the circles here, and the chevrons are like the crosswise, not chevrons, harlequins, then it won't look so weird altogether, right? Okay, so we're gonna keep this one. This is gonna be our big love one, unless we do it in the middle. That could be cool. All right, so what else do we got over here? Oh, smile. Look, there's smile. All right, we're gonna do smile. Where'd it go? So So since I'm just rollering it right on, or actually I'm going to hold the phone. I am going to dauber this one on. Because I want it to look like smile, right? Smile. Sweet. Okay, what is... Oh, I have awesome. Awesome. Awesome and hearts. Look how cute that is. Now, there's a good chance some of this will be covered. Right, as we do our layers. But I love that we're just kind of getting this word thing. I took a course, I signed up for a course from that nice Heidi Swap. And she is going to, so I'm going to be focusing on this journal on how to make my handwriting happier, that I like it better. Okay, so we have love, we have smile. I feel like we could do something. Hello? I don't want hello. Okay, what do we got over here? We've got, they love hello. There's you're the best. Magic. That's cool. I am magic. I don't want that on a... Ooh, here we go. I am magic. So this is a little bit of a translucent paint, this... I am magic. How cool is that? I love this stencil. Okay. Do, 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 do. Oh, is this gonna be our one? Okay. All right. So now, that isn't dry. I live in Florida, you guys, so literally it takes 5.5 years. Look, sopping wet. Takes 5.5 years for anything to dry. I spend my life waiting for paint to dry. All right, let's put something on here. You're the best. Okay, I have another set. They were like $3. Oh, yay. Okay. Best $3 I've ever spent in my life. Okay. So what do we got? Dreams. Follow your dreams. I'm just going to put dreams. I'm going to put it off the side. How fancy is that? All right. Let's use our real paint. These gel plates work great as a palette. Okay. Boop. Look at that. That is awesome. All right, what else does this one say? Reach for the stars. Away, away we go. Oh, that's weird. Let's have a All right, I'm willing to go for it. Yay. That's kind of a fun one. Oh, these are circly ones. Look, there's another circly one. Oh my goodness. Be brave. I definitely need to be brave. Now, if I was doing this on the jelly plate, I would flip it over backwards. I know, probably you knew that, but that was like a revelation to me that, oh, if I put it on the stencil on backwards, when I print it, it will be forwards. I know. You're thinking I'm brilliant. I know. All right, what else we got? Great. What is that? It's not great, that's great. You get what you pay for. Do great, be brave, be bold. We wanna be bold. Okay, let's see our last one. What do we got? Just be you. Love is love. I love, love is love. You know what we're gonna do right here? Little snoogie bits over here. Right, around the outside. There we go. That's cool. I got a big gloppy. So if you get a big gloppy, you know what you do with it? You spread it out so it looks like it's supposed to be there. But that's the thing that's messing me up right on this one. Okay, do we want a heart? Ooh, love. All right. All right, what about this page? Oh, I do want love is love somewhere. There we go. All right. Cool. All right. So that was fun. Now we're going to do this. Because I'm impatient. All right. So I have to clean this off. I like to clean it off around the edge of pages. Other people like to roller it down the middle, but for me, I don't love a page with like just a roller thing on it. It just doesn't do anything for me personally. Okay, so now we need to okay, I've been wanting to try a different color back paint rather than white, because white is very stark. So I went really expensive. I got the 99 cent Joann's cream color. Okay, so this is the first thing we're gonna do. We're gonna roller it out everywhere. And what happens with this is that all those layers, or the two layers on this one, of acrylic paint that are sitting there dried, when we do this, will pull up, and we are going to, usually I turn it over and do it, but for this one, and we're gonna push down really good. And you wanna kinda let that paint underneath soak into the paper before you pull it up. There we go. See See, there we got our love. Love. I love that. Now, this is a whole page of paint, right? Because I put the white paint down. So you're going to see that this, when we work on this one's going to be harder to do stuff with. But that's okay. So on this one, I'm going to do my flippy trick. I like having the acrylics so that I can see what I'm doing. There we go. That's cool. Ooh, here on our love. How fun is that? There we go. All right. So I'm going to keep messing around. I'll come back at the very end and do a flip through when I have all the background stuff done. Alrighty, so I have finished what I'm going to do for today. And one of the reasons why I don't want to do more, as I say, I'm finished and then I'm not finished. One of the reasons why I don't want to do more, and that glue stick did not stick this down very well, is because as I put layers on, so I have this that I want to put on, right? So I have this little woman that I'm going to have standing maybe on this thing, right? So I want to stick this down, and then I want to put more layers on top of her. So I'm not making these like super fantastical, amazing backgrounds right this second. I am, and then the cool thing about the Traveler's Notebook, is that you can put these in your little pouches. You can put them in here. So I'm gonna put this right here. And then I have it, and then when I figure out which page I'm gonna put it in, I can just stick it down, right? I think a glue stick for that kind of paper would be much better. This is like a lot for a glue stick to manage. So I put, remember I put this one upside down, but see this little circle sticks right in there. I love how this looks, and this is circles I made with the gel press plate. This one I just stuck on. I don't know what I'm going to do with it yet. And then love. I feel like this is more red than pink. I had really wanted it to be pink, but then I was too lazy to fix it. This is circles I made, and there's a tuck spot right here. Just a little background. This is the whole page that's paint. And then I have a mistake I want to show you. So I thought this one turned out okay. And this is a little tuck spot where I can put something. Okay, is it this one? No, it's not this one. This one's just gluing itself together. Okay, so that's cute. I love this. I got to do something fun with this. Okay, so what I figured out was when I stapled this on, I accidentally had this page, like there's a page in the middle. So now I have a tuck spot here and a tuck spot here. So that's a double tuck spot. It's like an amazing secret doubly tuck spot. Okay, this is a top tuck. And that one held. I wonder why some of them held. Maybe I didn't glue them enough. Anyways, you can use any kind of glue for this. I just happen to have my Mod Podge out, so I'm using that. I can't even pull that up. So it does work. Okay, we got this page. I love little mermaid scales. We got this page. This is another one I did upside down, but don't forget, stuff will stay in an upside down tuck spot. And so I'll probably do something super clever with that. And then this is the last page. So hopefully that helps. Tara Jacobsen, Artsy Fartsy Life.